as the sun sets on the baseball season, and with just 12 games left, the Giants have lost three straight, including last night against the D-backs. San Francisco needs a stopper, and the emotional Jake Peavy could be the right man for the job. Peavy will bring fire and passion to this important game two of the series. Giants, D-backs, and it's next. Get ready for Giants baseball. This is game two of this important three-game series, Giants and Diamondbacks. Hi again, everybody. I'm Dwayne Kuiper. Alongside me is Mike Kruko. Well, Wade Miley did the Giants in last night, and Giants are going to have to figure out a way to beat Josh Collmenter. But more importantly, it'll be up to Jake Peavy to calm the D-backs down.
Well, you're right. But, I mean, if history has anything to say about tonight's ball game, it does give the Giants a slight edge. Now, Peavy in his last six starts, 5-1 with a 1.12 ERA. He's confident. And you're going to have to be confident against Collmenter. He's never lost against the Giants. But the Giants here at Chase Field, 16-7 in the last 23 games. They haven't lost a series since April of 2012. You have to like those numbers. Bottom line is you have to like Peavy.
Yeah, and this is a game that they need to win badly. You cannot lose four in a row at this time of the year. It's Collmenter, it's Peavy, and it's game two of the series. Stay tuned. We'll take you to our Comcast Sportsnet studios for an update. It's presented by the Santa Cruz Beach Boardwalk. The admission-free boardwalk is open weekends. 84 degrees. Outside, 76 inside, humidity at 56%, and the roof is closed. Let's take a look at the Giants lineup, and it's brought to you by Coors Light. No Pagan, it'll be Blanco, Panic, and Buster Posey. And Buster Posey's got big, big numbers against Josh Collmenter. Sandoval, the cleanup hitter. Then it's Pence, Ishikawa, and Crawford. Perez in center field, he's hitting eighth, and Peavy ninth.
On the hill tonight for these Arizona Diamondbacks is going to be the right-hander Josh Collmenter, 6'4", 240-pounder in his fourth year at the big league level. Collmenter, 28 years of age, and here's what he's done at 25 starts. Started out the season in the bullpen, wound up in the rotation, and boy, is he taking advantage of that. 10-7 with a 3.67 ERA, 106 strikeouts against 38 walks. He's got great command, very unusual over-the-top release. He's got a high 80s fastball. He'll cut the fastball. He's got a 12-6 curveball and one of the best changeups in the National Leagues. A Trevor Hoffman-type changeup.
Ooh, that's pretty good.
It's a good one.
So here's Blanco. And the first pitch of the ball game is high. So we get started at 6:40, right on time. Blanco pops this one up, shallow left field, high enough for Inciarte to get there. And that's how this game gets started on a pop up to left.
Let's take a look at the Diamondbacks defense starting in the outfield from left to right. It'll be Inciarte, Pollock, and Jackson. Gregorius and Pennington on the left side of the infield, Owings and Trumbo on the right side. Miguel Montero will be in the squad, putting down the signs.
Here's Panic. 2-for-5 last night for Joe Panic as he takes a strike. He had two at bats against Collmenter last week, and he went 0-for-2. So Panic, and the 1-1 pitch from Collmenter is in tight. By the way, the home plate umpire is Ron Culpa. Barrett, DeMuth, and Woodring from first to third. There's Ron Culpa.
Yeah, he's got a big strike zone. Great pitcher's umpire. I think Culpa by nature is a low ball guy, but he will give some belts. And he definitely looks for strikes.
And that's right at Trumbo. Two outs.
All right, time now for our Togo's big play, the Togo's way. back to July 20th of last year, 2013, at AT&T Park. Posey against Collmenter. Whoop! El Centro, home run. The Giants went on to win that ball game, 4-3. Collmenter, however, did not get the loss. Collmenter has never lost the Giants. He's 3-0.
Buster 1-for-4 last night, and he shoots this one right at the third baseman Pennington. So Collmenter not fooling anybody. Peavy coming out. It'll be Ender Inciarte to lead things off. Then it's Owings, Pollock, and Trumbo hit a grand slam last night. That was a difference. Montero in the fifth spot. Then it's Pennington. Brett Jackson gets a start, followed by D.D. Gregorius. And Collmenter will pitch in bat ninth.
On the hill tonight for the Giants will be Jake Peavy, the 33-year-old right-hander, making his 10th start for the Giants. He's gone 5-4 with a 2.29 ERA and 9 starts with the Giants. On the whole entire year, 6-13 with a 3.93 ERA, 147 strikeouts, 183 innings pitched for Peavy. When you take your at-bats against him, you're going to see a low 90s fastball with sink. He will cut it. Got an outstanding changeup. He will throw a curveball, a slider, a lot of sliders. And just does about all the things that is required of a pitcher to do. Holds runners on well. He'll field his position well, provided it's hit to the right side of the infield. But smart. Lifetime against these D-backs, 15-12 with a 4.48 ERA.
Here's the pitch to Inciarte, and he fouls it out of play. Inciarte last night, 1-for-4. The Giants out hit the Diamondbacks last night. Really doesn't mean a whole lot other than the fact that they did get some hits.
You see the last six starts for Peavy. He's been on fire.
Fastball up and in at 89, one ball and one strike. On deck is Owings and then Pollock. Colorado leading the Dodgers 5-0. That game is in the fourth inning, and there's a base hit by Inciarte. So Peavy right away in the stretch.
Let's take a look at that Giants defense. Starting in the outfield from left to right will be Blanco, Perez, Pence, with Angel Pagan on the shelf again for a second night in a row. Crawford, Sandoval, they'll be on the left side of the infield. Panic and Ishikawa on the right side. And Buster Posey, he'll be in the squad putting down the signs.
Here's Owings. 1-for-3 last night. Scored a run. And Ciarte with 16 steals. He's been thrown out 3 times, so Peavy is going to try to give Buster Posey a shot at throwing him out. And a strike at the knees. Owings 1-for-3 lifetime against Peavy. Only Montero has had a lot of at bats against Peavy in this lineup. Pennington's had 8. D-backs have won 3 straight. The Giants have lost 3 straight. Last night was the start of a 9-game road trip. High and foul, and it's nothing and 2.
Let's take a look at our Nissan keys to the game. Number 1, Peavy and the low strike. This is a ballpark with lots of carry. It does not favor the fly ball. The sooner he gets down around the knees with that location, the better off he will be. And for the Giants, find the secret to Collmenter. He has had some ownage on him. Those are our Nissan keys to the game.
Panic.
Time now for our AT&T Universe Rewind. Last Thursday, Jake Peavy taking on these very same Diamondbacks. Went 5-2/3, gave up 6 hits, 1 earned run, had 0 walks, struck out 8. And in 92 pitches, he was stellar. Jazz would win that ball game. That is our AT&T U-verse rewind.
Here's Pollock.
Could Joe Panic have played that any differently?
I'm not sure. I'm not sure you can risk it if you were going to try to play it where you could maybe let it bounce first. Strike at the knees. Pollock last night went 1-for-3. He's only faced Peavy a couple of times and he's 1-for-2. Runs pretty well, hard guy to double up, but this is such a fast infield that most ground balls are going to get at you really quick.
A.J. Pollock is one of the guys that the Diamondbacks are really high on. He had nice credentials coming out of the minor leagues. He missed the entire 2010 year with a broken arm. Put him on the shelf, kind of set him back. But they are really pleased with his development this year as an everyday player.
He's a good center fielder. Pops this one up. More work for Panic. Here's our Geico quote. Here's Bochy on Vogelsong giving up a grand slam last night to Mark Jumbo. You take away that pitch, and it's a pretty good outing. And I think Vogelsong said that himself this morning in the papers.
Well, I don't even think he should even have had to pitch to Trumbo. I thought he had Pollock struck out on a 3-2 check swing. But hey, that's just the way the game goes. It can be very frustrating at times.
Down low, one ball and no strikes. Trumbo overall, 49 runs batted in, 1-for-8 are his career numbers against Peavy. Ishikawa, does he have room? You bet he does. Peavy pitches through a leadoff single. Sandoval, Pence, and Ishikawa coming up. Fair amount of Giants fans here tonight. It was a giveaway at AT&T Park, I think, on the last homestand.
The cat in the hat? Hat?
I haven't popped mine out yet. I know that a pretty good idea what your Christmas card is going to look like.
They're good attitude hats, man. Come on.
Sandoval fouls it out of play. Two for four last night for the Panda. Shoots this one into left and it's going to fall. I don't have any idea how that got down. I thought that would carry out unless it had some topspin.
Well, I agree. And Inciarte is a left fielder that could very easily be playing center field. He has great range. I thought this was just going to be a lazy fly ball, but Inciarte winds up playing back on it. So the Giants catch a bit of a break there.
Three line drives in a row, and here's Pence. Pence takes a strike. He's got a home run against Collmenter, but not much else. He's 3-for-21. He went 1-for-4 in the game last night. And that runs inside, and it's 0-1. Ishikawa on deck, and then Crawford. top of the second inning here at Chase Field. On the ground, backhanded, Pennington. That's one. That's two. And that's as good a double play as you're going to see.
Wow.
And still, Collmenter just giving up rockets.
You're right. I mean, he's not fooling anybody tonight. After Blanco's little fly ball, it's been bullet, bullet, line drive, rocket. Right. Missed anybody. Just absolutely scorches one down to Pennington. And really a nice turn there from Chris Owings, the second baseman. He doesn't get a great throw from Pennington. He has to catch the one hop back up and flat foot throw a strike over to get Pitts, and that's not easy.
Here's Ishikawa. Ishikawa hitting at 275. Three home runs, 18 driven in. One ball and one strike.
That's the 12-6 break that Collmenter gets on that curveball because of that high release. There's nobody in the National League that has a higher release than Collmenter. Big, big part of his gig is deception.
And Ishikawa is aboard.
Trying to throw that little flat cutter right on the belt. Throw that fastball about 70% of the time. It averages 86 miles per hour. Then that 12-6 curveball, and then the changeup. But the changeup makes it. I mean, it really is a good one. But he's also come up with a cut. You saw the pitch that just hit Travis Ishikawa. That's a cutter that he's come up with, and it's another good pitch for him, especially the lefties.
Here's Crawford hitting 237. And he hits this one foul. Just wide at first, and it's no balls and one strike. Crawford last night went 1-for-4. He knocked in a run. He's got 63 RBIs. He's a home run shy of double digits. Lines this one right at the center fielder, and that'll end the inning. It'll be Montero, Pennington, and Jackson coming up. Beat the Braves 8-5. Darren Lewis had a big night. Four walks, stole three bags, four runs scored. But here's the story. Rod Beck recorded his first career save. He had 199 with the Giants and a total of 286 overall. Shooter. He was a good Giant.
Shooter. Yeah, he was a good Giant, no doubt.
Here's Montero. Montero hitting 247, 71 driven in. 1-for-4 last night. There was a guy that climbed the mountain, got to the top, fell off the mountain, and then tried to get back up it again.
He was not boring. There was not a bone in his body that was boring. He was just a character. Total gamer. When we first saw him, he was a starting pitcher. You know, he didn't have blazing stuff.
Blanco caught it. Nice play.
I didn't get a chance.
Dug it out of the stands.
I'm telling my Rod Beck story. Talking about a great catch for Gregor Blanco.
Well, I can recreate it later on.
Yeah. Let's see you do it. Here we go.
Blanco reaches in and he puts it away.
That's our forward right choice. Would have picked me up. One more look. He's not even going to acknowledge that guy with the glove.
Give the guy the stink eye at least, don't you? Figure's too nice a guy. This is Pennington.
And that's foul back.
All right, one more look. He comes over, measures it out. I got this one. And then he's got to fight off a fan, and he never acknowledges him. That is not a happy left fielder. And that's not a happy hitter either.
Ishikawa to Peavy. And time to time, we'll take a look at what's going on in the West in the division race. Giants are 4 games back of the Dodgers. In the wild card, the Giants are 2.5 up on the Pirates, but a little bit more on the Brewers. So that's what's going on if the playoffs started today or tomorrow. There would be a home game at AT&T Park on October 1st. Here's Brett Jackson. And Jackson swings and misses. Nationals clinched. Congratulations. You know who's going to take credit for that?
F.P. Santangelo?
F.P. Santangelo, absolutely.
Kevin Franzen?
Kevin Franzen will. They'll actually be sparring to see who's going to take credit for it.
Well.
And we're going to give the credit to Matt Williams.
Further down the beltway, the Orioles are ahead in their ballgame, and they can clinch tonight.
That's right, in the same area, correct?
Yes.
They're both at home.
It's about 45 minutes apart from one another.
Brett Jackson, by the way, is 0 for 2 since he was put on this big league roster.
Jackson, a Bay Area kid.
A little breaking ball. It's 2-2. Yeah, he went to, he's from Palo Alto. He went to Cal as well. Two balls, two strikes. And this is bounce foul. Brett went to Miramane High School in Orinda.
Seats in the wall. Now that's a good concept right there. He's a golden oldie. They used to put unis on him, but they banged it, gave him a pair of khakis.
Double flats. Not close, 3-2s. Peavy not happy with that pitch.
Throwing a little curveball just a little bit high, perhaps. Jackson came over to the Diamondbacks from the Cubs August 14th by way of a trade.
He was a high pick. So here's Gregorius hitting at 207. And a strike, and it's 0-1. Gregorius 0-for-4 with a couple of strikeouts last night. While back, he had a pitch that he thought he could hit out of the park. He's got 6 home runs.
And all his power is middle away. And he really is a low ball hitter middle away. But he's got power. If you drop that thing in his wheelhouse, he'll hit it out. And he's got power to left. in this ballpark.
So it's 0-2.
No wind in this ballpark. Pretty fast gaps in the outfield. Fast infield, not as fast as we've seen it. And not the fastest one in the National League West. That honor belongs to Coors Field.
Well, that's the fastest in the history of the game.
It's quick.
This is out to Perez, and that'll end the inning. No runs, a walk, one left for the Giants. It'll be Perez, Peavy. Might find that end of the tree this year.
The catch.
Here's Perez. Perez took an 0 for 5 last night. And he takes a strike. Never faced Collmenter before. And that's cue foul, nothing in two. A young hitter with not a lot of experience. Collmenter's probably licking his chops.
I think most veteran pitchers feel that way about a young kid.
One 2 pitch hit into center field. Pollock will put it away. And here's Peavy. Peavy's in a slump.
Yeah, he's 0 for 2014. That's a slump. Career wise, he's got some pretty good numbers. Hitting .166 with a couple of big flies. I mean, that's good.
He's going to try to knock one out of the yard right here.
He does leave his feet.
Collmenter knows it too.
Just throw lazy little cutters on the outside. That's a tough pitch to hit. If you're a pitcher, you don't see that pitch very often.
There's a strike. Two balls and one strike.
Can you take it all the way?
Foul back above us, right above Tom Candiotti, two booths down. One of the radio voices of these Diamondbacks, the old knuckleballer. Peavy, fly ball, right field. On the move is Jackson, still on the move, and he'll reach up and make the catch.
Well, I mean, for as hard as the Giants have hit the ball this first time through the lineup, they haven't got a lot to show for it. Here's Tom Candiotti, product of St. Mary's, Moraga. Good guy.
Mom still lives in Concord. He's a good guy. The only time I really didn't care for him is when he was with the Dodgers. And I guess the Dodger uniform will do that.
Yeah, that's how it works.
A strike to Blanco, who popped out to open up the ball game.
We can't help that.
Part of the deal. Foul. Tom Candiotti made a nice career out of that knuckleball.
His was funky too, because it was a straight downer. I mean, if you hit off of Phil Negro, he could make it go right, he could make it go left. But Candiotti's a kind of flutter, and then boom. But he can throw the pitches, though. I mean, curveball, slider. He can pitch.
Blanco stays alive with that tough changeup.
Take all the knuckleballs that you've seen. Joe Negro, this was kind of a hard one. Bigger break than his brother Phil. Charlie Huff. He had a good one.
Wilbur Wood.
That was a left-handed knuckleball.
Pulled foul. One ball, two strikes. Two and two. Panic is on deck. Blanco trying to reach for Panic. And it will not happen. And that's the first strikeout for Collmenter. Collmenter's going to lead things off. It's no score is Peavy facing Collmenter. And Collmenter takes a called strike. Collmenter 6 for 51 on the season. He's got a couple of runs batted in. And he taps this one slowly out in front of home plate. And Buster Posey will make the soft toss. It's kind of the beauty of having the pitcher lead off.
You know,
two pitch out.
That's hard to do, though. Take a full swing and hit the ball that far. I think it's harder to do that than it is to hit a home run.
Or strike out.
Or strike out.
So here's Inciarte, who opened up the bottom of the first with a line single up the middle. And the pitch is wide. One ball and no strikes.
First pitch changeup. First time he's done that. Throwing the first pitch off speed changeup. Posey suggested about four pitches there, and each time Peavy shook it off, he definitely has something in mind.
Slaps this one off the backstop. It's one ball and one strike. Pitch one and two.
Fastball in above the hands.
Blanco playing Inciarte perfectly, two outs.
Yeah, that's an out you have to go over to your coach and set the defense and say, nice going, you did good. That would be Roberto Kelly, who places the outfield. There's Roberto. Took off his hat.
Running his fingers through his hair. Just off the plate to Owings.
A low maintenance guy.
Yeah. And that's ruled foul. Cody Ross with the hat catch coming out of the dugout. Not close. Two balls and a strike.
Peavy could give you a little variance too with this, his arm angle. I mean, he could go from a regular three quarter down to almost a sidearm. He'll do that with his breaking ball to flatten it out, especially against righties.
Two and two. Two balls, two strikes. And Owens fought off a good pitch. Two and two. And the 2-2. Here it is. And he swung and missed. And Buster didn't catch it. And Owens is out. Kind of odd. That whole play was odd. And a really good job by the play-by-play man calling that.
Got him.
He gone. Desert, it's nothing, nothing. You have a nice wide screen in the back of our booth. We're enjoying watching the Nationals celebrate with champagne and the Orioles celebrate with champagne. At least it looks like champagne.
Oh yeah, it is definitely sparkling wine, but it's one of the advantages of playing in San Francisco. Champagne or the sparkling wine's better.
Pretty good. Panic at a line drive to Trumbo in the first inning. Here he lifts this one to left field, and Ciarte is going to put it away. So here's Posey. Buster hit a bullet to Pennington in the first. Pablo Sandoval on deck.
Now, prior to tonight's ball game, we talked about the success that Posey has had against Collmenter, and you can see he's used the whole field.
Hits it high. Hits it deep. It is out of here. And the Giants lead 1-0. Number 21 for Buster Posey. And he decided to get one up in the air where nobody could catch it.
Just a little golf shot. And look at all the guys in this Giants lineup who historically have just not been able to get time to Collmenter, but Posey, not a problem.
Sandoval shoots one right back for a base hit. And that'll bring up Hunter Pence.
Take a look at the side swing. Look at the location right at the knee. Just goes down and yanks it right into the bleachers. And for Posey, run number 21. And it breaks the ice. Boy, it's Ciarte. The way he went back on the ball, I was thinking he had a chance on it. It just runs out of real estate. See ya.
Here's Pence. Pence hit a rocket on the ground to Pennington. And he takes wide, one ball and no strikes.
Pence, one more home run, he'll be in the 20 club.
It's the 18th home run that Collmenter has allowed. There's a strike.
Okay, that's the big balloon changeup. You see the numbers, 10 for 16 with three homers and a double. That's orange. I mean, that's hard to do that against a guy in batting practice, let alone in a big league ball game.
Right back up the middle. Juggled by Owings. And he does, however, recover and get the force play at second. He doesn't juggle it, he's got a double play. So here's Ishikawa. Ishikawa got hit on the hip. In the second inning. Pence with 13 steals. He's been thrown out six times. Pence leaning just a little bit. And it. It's Collmenter in a spot where he really has to keep an eye on Pence. But
you know, this is the time of year you start looking at the guy's stats to see what they're going for. If they're two solo bases short of 20 or one home run short of 15 or whatever, you can have a pretty good idea of what they're trying to do when they're at bat or if they're on the base pass.
To Ishikawa. Ishikawa steps out just briefly. Everybody's ready. Ball and one strike. Pence at first being held on by Trumbo. Buster Posey, home run number 21. He comes with one out here in the fourth inning. And it's bye bye, baby. Bottom of the fourth coming up, 1-0 Giants.
Of the San Francisco Giants. It may not be reproduced or retransmitted in any form, and the accounts and descriptions of this game may not be disseminated without the express written consent of San Francisco Baseball Associates, LLC.
Well, Saturday, September 27th is Yoga Day at the park. Your special event package will include access to the on-field post-game yoga session and an Orange Giants yoga mat and a game to see the Giants take on the Padres. Go to sfgiants.com/special events.
Here's Pollock. No swing. Pollock popped out to panic. So it's 2-0 to Pollock. Pollock in the swing mode, two balls and one strike. You got a hanger.
Now, those are what you want a second crack at. If you miss it, go up there looking for one good pitch to hit. That was one good pitch to hit.
Hit down the right field line. Pence will give chase, but that's going to be in the seats. 2-0 though, you're not thinking hanging breaking ball. You're thinking really good fastball to hit.
Yeah, most guys will look fastball middle away.
Three and two now to Pollock. Peavy walked Brett Jackson in the second. Got him.
Inside fastball. See you later. Thanks for stopping by. Strikeout number two for Peavy. Too about Ron Copa. You don't have to put the ball between the catcher's knees to get a strike. They set that target away. This ball comes across the plate in the inside corner. Clearly outside the knees of Posey, but Copa, if you're in his zone, see you later. And he is not afraid to ring you up.
Here's Trumbo. Trumbo popped out to Ishikawa in foul territory to end the first. Skies this one into shallow center field. Perez broke back and he's not going to get there. And Trumbo's got a double. That ball's in the air a long time for that to fall.
Well, I mean, your call, it was perfect. I mean, Juan Perez just did not react to it very well. He goes back in the ball. Now he's got to regroup and come in. What should have been just an easy play winds up being a two base hit simply because Perez thought he was getting a whole lot more fly ball.
So here's Montero. Montero popped out to Blanco, who made a nice play by reaching into the stands. Perez moves back comfortably underneath this one. Two outs. And that'll bring up Pennington. So Pennington with Trumbo at second base, two outs. And the first pitch high and wide, one ball and no strikes. Brett Jackson's on deck. This is the rook.
And I think Peavy is more comfortable throwing to Pennington than he would be throwing to Jackson. Simply because he knows Pennington. He doesn't know a whole lot about Jackson.
Perez. Side retired, so the double by Trumbo does not hurt Peavy. It'll be the bottom three of the Giants lineup. It's 1-0 San Francisco.
Fifth inning. Giants one run on three hits. Arizona no runs on two hits. It'll be Brandon Crawford leading off here for San Francisco. Crawford 0 for 1 in his first at bat. Hit a bullet to center field. First time through the lineup, there were six hard hit balls against Collmenter.
Perez on deck. First pitch is low, and then Peavy. And it's high, 2-0. Mr. Posey, the difference in this game right now is solo home run, 1-0 Giants. Crawford takes a strike.
A lot going around baseball today. Nationals clinch, Orioles clinch. There's a little story coming out of Houston that's pretty cool.
Down the left field line. Inciarte over. It's a fair ball. Crawford will hit into second base with a leadoff double. And let's check in with Greg Papa in our studio for this update. Time of the year now where you watch the scoreboard for a number of different teams, and the Pirates are one of them. Here's Perez. Perez takes a strike. Milwaukee's another one.
Milwaukee
losing tonight in St. Louis 2-1.
Atlanta's pretty much fallen off the face of the earth. They got beat again.
Atlanta today, groundbreaking. New yard.
How about that? Going to be open in 2017.
Place they play in now, such a dump.
It's a great ballpark.
There's a foul down right field line and out of play. Now, look, Fulton County Stadium.
Yeah,
they could have blown that up 2 days after they built it. But Turner,
my favorite.
Turner Field.
It's a good yard.
It's a good yard.
Plus, it's got some history to it. But that story out of Houston I was talking about is Jose Altuve tonight got his 211th hit, and that's a record for the Astros. What a year that guy's had.
Up the middle. They're going to go to third, and Crawford is out at third. So with a fast infield, that's going to happen. Time to log on to CSNBayArea.com and decide the player of the game. The winner will be revealed during Giants postgame live. Check out the enhanced Bloomberg stats. Giants in game live on CSNBayArea.com. Log on and vote. So now Peavy will be asked to bunt. And he does. And it is an absolute perfect bunt. And Perez now in scoring position. So here's Gregor Blanco. Blanco's really not picked up Collmenter well at all. Plus he's 2-for-15 lifetime against Collmenter. Strike and it's 0-1.
Some guys you just have no chance with. We were hitting off his Rick Sutcliffe was funky. Almost like he planted his front foot, then it was a delay for his arm to get up and release, and he just I couldn't time him. I don't know how anybody hit him. Collmenter, same type of guy. Higher release, but just funky. Funkiness is good, provided you're not hurting your arm. If you've got a little something unusual in your delivery that upsets the timing of a hitter, so that's good stuff.
Foul. Nothing in two.
Guy moves pretty good. There we go. He doesn't know it, but he's psyched.
Yeah, he'll figure that out pretty soon. Oh, and two to Blanco. Way high. Blanco in a battle right now. Timeout is called.
Of all the Giants hitters, the one guy who will not get frozen in the batter's box is Gregor Blanco. He steps out a lot if a guy becomes very slow and deliberate on the mound.
Well, he'll step out for no reason. Another bullet foul.
He's wearing the ball dude out. Although this guy looks like he's got some mileage left in him.
Are you kidding? He ran a marathon this morning.
He did.
He's doing great.
He ran over here from Tempe.
He's got his brand spanking new balances on. He's psyched.
Yeah, old southpaw, but he still plays. He's got the look. In fact, as far as I'm concerned, that could be Warren Spahn sitting there.
It might be.
They had an old timers game one time in San Diego, and Warren Spahn was about 68. He came and pitched the inning. It's the best curveball we saw all year.
Yeah, he and Marichal, even at 68, could get people out.
And that is not an exaggeration.
Rockies have added a couple of more runs. It's 7-2 Colorado.
Some guys get good genes. Other guys get stuck with a pair of corduroys.
Yep, they got to buy them. Two balls, two strikes. Hit off the end of the bat to Gregorius. And now in the inning. Wasted double. Jackson, Gregorius, Collmenter are coming up.
Guys,
here's the Christmas card. Some folks are going to get in the mail around December 15th, 20th, maybe.
Yeah.
Here's Brett Jackson. And a strike to Brett Jackson.
Nice little backdoor cut.
Inside corner, nothing in two.
Elevator fastball.
Got him.
Beauty.
And here's Gregorius.
See, I think that's one of the things you see a lot of at the big league level. You don't see a lot of at the minor league level, and that's change of sight lines. I mean, pitchers up here, I mean, they really understand the importance of establishing knee high in the eye of a hitter and then raising it above the letters and having the ability to throw that pitch. It's not an easy pitch to throw. Because if you miss down, you're right in the sweet spot. If you get it up there, change sight lines, a guy can't lay off. It's a good pitch.
Plus, aren't you taught to keep the ball down?
Taught to keep the ball down, yes, indeed. So for Brett Jackson, he just needs to get some reps up here, get some at bats before he learned how to deal with that.
Popped up. Perez. Two outs here in the fifth. And here's Collmenter.
But that's one of those reasons why veteran pitchers think that they have an advantage on a young hitter.
Collmenter dribbled out in front of home plate. Posey threw him out.
You know, I think you could go to Hudson, Peavy, Matt Cain, Vogelsong and say, listen, you can't use any other pitch but a fastball. You can change the grips and you can move the location around, but you can't use any other pitch but a fastball. And they could get the job done. And it takes you a while to learn how to use that fastball. Two different types of grips. Difference between knee-high location and belt high location.
Crawford with nice rhythm onto Ishikawa, and that'll end the inning. Panic, Posey, Sandoval, Pence, Ishikawa, all coming up as we enter the sixth.
Area.com.
All right, I get the message.
Comcast SportsNet now has 49ers pregame live during home games, along with 49ers postgame live every week. Watch postgame live to win 49ers tickets to sold out Levi Stadium.
I get the message.
Are you in? Of course you are.
Here's Panic. Panic is lined out. He's flied out. Milwaukee, by the way, tied that game in the ninth inning against the Cardinals. So they are headed to the Cardinals half of the ninth. Panic takes low. Swing and a miss. One ball and one strike.
Nice 1-0 change up there. When we first saw Collmenter, he's kind of a two-pitch guy. Not anymore.
Panic bounces out, and here's Buster Posey. Buster hit his 21st home run in the fourth inning.
Well, he was right to the glove. They set up on that inside corner, and he just tees it up and says four. Golf shot. About a 900.
He threw him the same pitch. It's no balls and one strike. Sandoval on deck. In the dirt, two balls and one strike. They got a vendor here that is the same vendor that is barking at us during spring training at Scottsdale Stadium. It's the lemonade man.
Lemonade like grandma made.
Yeah, that's the guy. He's actually selling beer tonight.
Beer like grandma made.
Like grandma partook in. There's our gentleman. 3-1 to Buster Posey. Posey to left, but it's right at Inciarte. Two outs. And here's Sandoval.
Sandoval.
Sandoval's got two singles in the game. Right now trying to get on for Hunter Pence. Sandoval in a 2-0 count. Can lean on one here if he likes it. And he does. It's 2-1.
Well, he got that fastball he's looking for right there, middle in at the belt. Set the target. Really doesn't have to move the glove a whole bunch.
Right below the knees, it's 2-2. Out of play. And the 2-2 offering to Sandoval. Sandoval, a little pop up down the left field line, and that's going to be foul. So we'll get to see another pitch.
So one thing about Collmenter, I think along with that really deceptive change that he has great ability to go inside or outside with it, depending on what he's trying to do with it.
This is going to be foul, but it's going to be fun to watch. Not sure Sandoval could do anything to keep that ball fair.
Collmenter, the previous pitch was soft stuff away. Here he goes hard stuff up and in. You're right. I don't know if he could have stayed inside that pitch.
Waited on the big curveball. It stays at 2-2.
That was a 66 mile an hour balloon right there.
Somewhere, Levon Hernandez is smiling. This will be the ninth pitch coming up in this at bat. Three and two. So Sandoval gets to see a 3-2 pitch with Pence on deck. Taps it slowly, kicks off the mound, and that'll end the inning. Top of the order, Inciarte's gonna lead things off. It's 1-0 Giants as we go to the Diamondbacks half of the sixth inning. Inciarte, Owings, and Pollock. Jake Peavy with 58 pitches on the night. This is foul back on the first pitch fastball to Inciarte. Inciarte singled in the first, hit a fly ball to left in the third inning. Blanco moving back, and Blanco will make the catch. One out.
One thing Peavy has done a really nice job of tonight is moving the ball around. He's been on both sides of the plate with fastball. He's sunk the fastball. He's cut the fastball. His backboard sliders. He's really mixed location. Beautiful.
Owings has hit a soft line drive to second, and then he struck out in the third. Pollock on deck. Foul back, nothing in two.
Always believe if a guy can pitch, if he understands movement location. If he sees a team two starts in a row, it's advantage to the pitcher the second time. I don't believe that is an advantage to a young pitcher, a thrower. A guy like Peavy and Collmenter for that matter, I mean, they've got a lot of things they can do with the ball, and they read hitters well. That's a great 0-2 pitch, and that's just a little two seam fastball. I tried to bring back into the strike zone. I don't know if he missed that wide or if it was low, but it did miss by much. Now you can throw a slider off the same location.
Two and two.
A little wide, kind of an easy take there. And the other thing too with Owings that he's done tonight is he's gotten inside when he's needed to. Throwing that two seam fastball, and he's really running in on the hands of Owings a couple, two, three times. And that inside corner set up right now. See Buster Posey seeing where Owings sets up in the box. He wants to go away.
Hit well into center field. Perez on the move, and it's a big bounce up against the wall. And this will be a triple for Owings.
Now they had Juan Perez playing on the right field side of center field, and that really split the gap between Blanco and Perez. And one of the few mistakes in location he's made tonight. That was out over the plate at the belt. And Owings in a two strike swing. That's a good jolt. And these are big time gaps for triples if you're a guy with speed.
So the infield will play back. And this pop up is out of play. It's 0-1. The 0-1 to Pollock, and that's foul. It's nothing in two.
And he was looking in. But with that flat movement running in towards the belt, I mean, it's almost impossible for Pollock to stay inside it. And all he could do was hook it foul. So in a strikeout situation, Posey on top of him very quickly, 0-2. And with that 0-2 count, Giants are bringing that infield in. Posey suggested a fastball up across the letters, and Peavy stepped off.
One and two. Jumbo on deck. Infield in. Pass Sandoval, and this game is tied. So Pollock with an RBI single.
And I don't know if Sandoval was playing back deep, if he'd have had a chance to get that, the ball was raked. Nice two strike at bat for Pollock.
So here's Jumbo.
Panda played deep with the bag. He may have had a better shot at it, a little bit deeper. Still nice two strike hit. And we get a brand new ball game.
Pollock, 12 steals. He's been caught twice. On the ground, Sandoval to Panic to Ishikawa. And that double play ends the inning. We'll go to the seventh. It's a brand new ball game. 1-1. We're on even terms. Buster Posey's got a home run. Owings a triple and a run scored. And as we head to the seventh, it's a 1-1 ball game. It'll be Hunter Pence to lead things off. Pence, Ishikawa, Crawford.
Giants trying to wake up this offense that has absolutely gone dormant.
Pence fouls it back. Pence hit the ball hard in the second, ended up being a double play ball, and then he reached on a fielder's choice in the fourth. Look out, and there's a base hit right over Collmenter.
Well, fans, the next time you're looking to pick up great seats to the game, head to StubHub, where you can earn 2% back in fan rewards on every purchase, including Giants tickets. Plus, with all the pricing, there are no surprise fees at checkout. StubHub, your ticket to upgrades and more.
Ishikawa hit by a pitch and then hit a line drive that was caught by Trumbo. Pence, 13 steals.
Swing.
Ain't gonna miss.
That's frustrating too for an offense. I mean, you think back to Friday night when they beat the Dodgers 9-0, and after that game, they have really been quiet with the bats. You come into a game like tonight against Collmenter, first time through the lineup, you hit six really hard balls off Collmenter. You got with the little bird left on the rock to show for it. And that can frustrate you when you've been struggling to score runs.
Ishikawa. Pence is going to hit the bag at second. He will go to third, and the Giants with runners at the corners with nobody out.
And he went down and beat a pretty good pitch, too. That ball was not up.
Yeah, I thought there was a little bit more behind it, like it might get in the gap, and it turned out. I think he hit it towards the end of the bat.
Just a little bit below the knees, middle end. And I agree with you. I think he caught it a little bit off the sweet spot up the bat. But still an easy take, a third for Hunter Pence. And the Giants are in the driver's seat, first and third, nobody out. And look at Pence go. That's a good stroke right there.
So here's Crawford, who doubled in the fifth inning. And he hits one into center field. Pence is going to tag. Ishikawa is going to bluff. And the Giants retake the lead.
Nice at bat. You know, and that was one of those at bats you don't want to leave it up to somebody else.
No, you don't.
And he jumped on the first pitch he had in the strike zone. Collmenter trying to get a quick 0-1. And Crawford made him pay. Nice AB.
So here's Perez. Perez is 0-for-2. And a breaking ball low and away. One ball and no strikes.
Cy Angel Pagano, the Giants bench. Let's sit out another night. Back acting up. And he may not play tomorrow.
Popped up into shallow right field. So in this series now, Perez is 0-for-8. So here's Peavy.
Pitcher Jake Peavy.
Peavy is 0-for-1. He had a sacrifice bunt in the fifth inning. On the ground, knocked down by Pennington, and that'll end the inning. Giants retake the lead. It's 2-1 San Francisco. Peavy goes back out after making the last out. So Giants trying to take care of business, knowing that the Rockies have a 7-2 lead on the Dodgers. As they need three more outs in that game to help the Giants. See the line for both pitchers.
That's been a duel. Peavy very economical through six. Just 75 pitches, I mean, or just 70. That, you'd take that after five full, let alone six full. So that gives you an idea as to how economical he has been.
Montero has hit two balls in the air and he's 0-for-2. First pitch swinging and it's in the dirt 0-1. Ten hits in the game, six for the Giants, four for the D-backs. Hit out into left field for Blanco.
Well, the most popular way to follow the Giants push to the postseason is with MLB.com at bat, the number one app for live baseball. Enjoy live look-ins, replay reviews, scores, live radio broadcasts, the MLB TV game of the day, and more. Get at bat for your smartphone or tablet on the App Store or visit MLB.com. Always you can tell about Miguel Montero, the D-backs catcher, who just flied out. I mean, kind of wears his emotion on his sleeve. But I tell you, when you're pitching against a guy like Montero, and he makes it out, he does the Gumby shoulders, that fuels a pitcher. Now watch the reaction after he flies out. That fills up a pitcher's gas tank. You don't think Peavy doesn't enjoy that?
Well, I'll agree with Montero. He had a pretty good pitch to hit. And in a one-run game, trying to tie it up with one swing of the bat. Pennington hits one out to Perez. Two outs. And here's Brett Jackson. 9-2 Rockies right over the Dodgers.
How about the Rockies, huh? Hey, Giants know too well the effects of Coors Field. And the other thing is that when the Dodgers leave Colorado, they go to Wrigley Field. And they get the Cubs, who've been playing pretty good ball since Rizzo has come back off the he was on the DL, but he was injured.
swing. He ain't gonna miss. No balls and one strike.
But as you said yesterday, you have to assume they're gonna win every game.
Assume it. I mean, I'm assuming they're gonna come back and win this one. There's a call strike. It's another than two. It's kind of how I deal with things. I like to be shocked. They did? They did?
They won? Well, I'm thinking 9-2, even Coors Field, that one's over. By the way, that was a great 0-2 scud there for Peavy. There's the good news coming out of Colorado.
Two balls, two strikes.
You know, it's kind of funny though. I mean, for the most part this year, I think all of baseball was kind of rooting for Milwaukee to win that division. The Cardinals have been at that, have held that distinction for a long time. You kind of wanted to see somebody new. Now, it's like you root for the Cardinals.
Get to Ishikawa, to Peavy covering, side retired.
Nice hit.
Which is right up your alley. You can join us tomorrow. Game Live is going to start at noon. We'll have the first pitch right at the bottom of the hour at 12:30 right here on Comcast Sportsnet Bay Area. It'll be the Giants and the D-backs, and this, of course, is your home for the San Francisco Giants. It's Comcast Sportsnet. Madison Bumgarner will be on the hill. Top of the order for the Giants, it'll be Gregor Blanco. Blanco is 0-3. Here he takes low, one ball and no strikes.
That's the pitch he's not picking up.
Two and 0.
Yeah, give me two lefties going head to head tomorrow. Andrew Chafin for the D-backs.
There's a strike. Panic on deck. Out of play, it's 2-2.
Talk about the success that Blanco has had down the lineup compared to the success he hasn't had at the top of the lineup. Why would that make a difference?
That's a really good question. It's high, 3-2. And maybe you just relax a little bit more at the bottom of the lineup. Another line drive, one out.
Or maybe you just hit Adam Bones. That was a good at bat.
Panic 0-3. And a strike.
And he hasn't thrown that curveball very much today or tonight. But nobody's done anything with it when he's throwing it. And backs it up with a changeup. So two really good off-speed pitches. And the advantage goes to Collmenter, 1-2 in the count. And he is softballing Joe Panic.
Right back to Collmenter.
Buster,
high to Buster Posey.
Posey lined out the first, hit a home run, then flied out.
And a base hit.
You know, I got to believe in the eye of Buster Posey. It's like batting practice against this guy. He is not messed up timing wise at all.
So here's Sandoval. And the ball, it's 2 for 3. And he takes a strike, and it's 0-1. Down the left field line, that's going to be foul. So Collmenter out in front. Now no balls and two strikes. Very high, 1-2.
High with the fastball, down below with the breaking ball.
Same ball, that's for time.
Montero does not want to see Collmenter throw a strike here.
But Sandoval hits that low pitch so well. And he pulls this one foul.
Under that inside corner with the fastball.
Buster Posey with his lead. It's 1-2 to the Panda. Target is away. And Sandoval fouls it out of play.
Saw him, man. That's good balance in the swing. About the standard size bat that most guys use.
Taps this one to Owens, and that'll end the inning. It'll be Gregorius, a pinch hitter, and then Enciarte. The match on KNBR 680, the sports leader. Gregorius to lead things off here in the eighth inning.
Giants taking away the bunt, the third base side.
And a strike in its 0-1. Gregorius is flied out to center field twice. Swing and a miss, nothing and two. Dodgers have scored two and they've got another runner on in the ninth.
So what's the score?
10-4. Week has just hit a home run. Foul back.
You set that target with that fastball inside against Gregorius, and Peavy twice now has missed out over the play. As you see, Jeremy Affeldt and Sergio Romo start to get heated up in the Giants bullpen.
He got rid of that baseball.
Yeah, it didn't feel like it had the outs in it.
One and two.
Nice pitch. That's two seam fastball. That's exactly what Posey wanted the last pitch. Now that pitch there with its movement coming back the inside corner, you could go back to the same side of the plate with a cut fastball. You can back foot him with a slider, change up away, elevate above the hands, and a lot of different options.
That's going to drift into the seats about five, maybe six rows back.
Cross glove.
Perez, one out.
The Giants had to play perfectly defensively. Now, if Perez is on the right side of center field, that's extra bags, maybe three. So, Roberto Kelly, nice.
Jake Lamb is going to pinch hit.
Chance to see Jake Lamb in San Francisco. What we found out about him is he's got some pretty good pop the opposite way. It's a really nice left center, left field at bats against the Giants in San Francisco.
And a strike, and it's 0-1. Two.
First pitch, breaking ball, just flop it over, strike one, then elevate the fastball. And just like that, bang, bang, Jake Lamb's 0-2. Keep climbing that ladder.
In tight. Tried to sneak a fastball in, 1-2.
You feel better now?
Yeah, I do.
All right. Dodgers out hit him 16-9.
Lamb's had a couple of pitches to hit. It stays at 1-2.
Yeah, that's the danger of that chest high fastball, especially late in the ball game in a one run lead. If you miss just a little bit lower than the letters across his chest, that's a fat pitch.
Got him.
Comes back with a little backdoor cut up, gets a swing through. And it's always nice to send a guy packing that's got a little power in his bat, like Lamb.
Here's Inciarte, who's 1-for-3. there's a base hit into left field.
Nice opposite fielder bat there for Ciarte. Now you have a base dealer on the bag. That changes things a bit.
So Owens is coming up. He tripled in the sixth inning. Bruce Bochy is coming up the steps. Uh-oh, he's got the jog going.
If he's got the jog going, he's got a, you have a chance to talk him out of it. Peavy does not want to come out. And this one, you'll see a manager look right into the eyes.
Well, it's pretty funny. He walked out there and he didn't say anything. He just looked at Peavy, waiting for Peavy to say something to him.
Now, if there's anybody that knows Peavy, it's Bruce Bochy. Remember, he brought him into the big leagues. He's known him since he was an 18-year-old kid. But I do believe this is his last hitter.
And they got to keep an eye on Inciarte as well. He's got 16 steals. And a strike in its own one.
Got that little two seamer in the outside corner. Has been there whenever he's wanted to throw it tonight. Remember the last at bat that Owens had, he beat him the gap in left center with a mistake up. Got to keep the ball down here.
Came in tight, nothing in two.
Now, I think it's there on the inside. Every time they've run that little two seamer in on him, he's had a problem with it. The only thing is if you're going to go way inside at an 0-2 count here, you run the risk of hitting it. But you have to bear down. We saw what Owings did in his last at bat with two strikes.
And two.
Posey wants to go right back inside again.
Look out, and that hit him.
And that's the problem with that pitch.
And that's it. You were right. So Pollock's coming up. Sergio Romo's coming in. Peavy's going to walk off with a one-run lead. When it's time for a change, think Speedy. Oil change and auto service.
For the Giants, it's Sergio Romo. Let's take a look at what he has done. In 59 games this year, 5-4 with a 4.00 ERA, 56 strikeouts and 54 innings. Romo, the close early in the year at 23 saves. Now sets up for Santiago Casilla. Right-handers hitting 175, four pitches, 88 to 90 with the fastball, two types of grip, here for a two-seam, changeup, and a no-dot slider, his bread and butter.
Pollock with a run-scoring single in the sixth. Side, one ball and no strikes. Pollock is 0-for-6 in his career against Sergio Romo. Two and 0. kind of count on a right-handed hitter at least swinging at one of those two. But Pollock hasn't done that.
Well, with two outs, he's got an open base here. He can pick away at him. He doesn't have to challenge.
And he gets the strike there, 2-1.
Well, that's picking away. That's a perfect pitch. If there's one out, runners in first and second, you don't have the luxury of an open base, but with two outs, you do. And that is something that he knows very well. What you count on here is a hitter wanting to knock that run in and expanding his zone. And that's what Romo wants him to do, swing at his location.
2-2, came back with a fastball.
And that's his best bolt. And Pollock was late. You see Romo hit 90 with the fastball. That's backs out. He's digging deep for a challenge fastball. And Pollock was tardy. Now with Romo, slider options are on both sides of the plate. And we've seen him go inside. He does that about 20% of the time. Most of it goes away.
Side retired. Ooh means ooh. We'll go to the ninth. 2-1 Giants.
Performance of Jake Peavy, who was solid through 7 2/3 for Peavy. 5 hits allowed, 1 run. 1 walk, 4 strikeouts, 1 hit batsman. Just a stellar performance, matching zeros and effort with Mr. Josh Collmenter. And for PB's great effort tonight, he's our Honda player of the game.
Giants now will try to see if they can add on here in the ninth. The new pitcher is Will Harris, and Hunter Pence stands in. When it's time for a change, think Speedy Oil Change and Auto Service, your oil change tune-up and repair experts.
Will Harris in for the 25th time this year, 0-3 with a 4.91 ERA, 31 strikeouts, 0-25 2/3. He's got a nice cut fastball, a throw it a lot, low 90s velocity, curveball, slider, changeup, but a lot of cutters. I like that.
Here's the 0-2. Ishikawa on deck.
Harris, just a four pitch guy, kind of a journeyman until he discovered the cutter, and all of a sudden really elevated his presence in the bullpen.
Hunter Pence loves that pitch. It stays at 1-2.
And the thing about a cutter, and with Harris, it's a high 3/4 release. It's pretty subtle. It's a little 3 or 4 inch slide away from a righty into a lefty. And he fell in love with it. Throws a lot.
Rolls this one on the ground. Pennington gets rid of it quickly. And here's Ishikawa. So Kirk Gibson's coming out. We're going to get a new pitcher. It's 2-1 Giants, and we'll be back. Comcast Sportsnet Bay Area. Reaction to this game, you get Andrew Baggerly and his postgame notes. And the 49ers, they're in preparation for the Cardinals. Arizona Cardinals. They're pretty good too.
New pitcher now for the Diamondbacks will be Yuri De La Rosa, and he's a four pitch guy. Got a little funkiness to him. You'll see these occasional 90 with the fastball, but good breaking balls. He's not a big guy. He's 5'9", 165 pounder. A little over a year at the big league level. Really good quick breaking balls. Quick arm action.
Ishikawa looks at a strike and a big hit in the seventh inning.
But you stand next to Yuri De La Rosa and you think you're standing next to the ball dude.
In or size, not age.
Yeah. In size.
Just wide to Ishikawa. 1-for-3, or make that 1-for-2 tonight.
But hey, if he comes to your school and he's given an appearance and he's the speaker of the day, he can inspire a lot of kids.
That's right.
There's a lot of little guys there in that school thinking, man, I got a chance if this guy's in the big leagues. But he's a quality arm, and he does have four looks he'll give you. And he's not afraid to throw any of those pitches he has in a 3-2 count.
Ishikawa high in the left center field, and it's tracked down by Pollock. Ishikawa gave it a pretty good ride, two outs.
Well, Pollock had been set up in the left center field side, and it was kind of a pitch him away, play him away defense. And I think that the Diamondbacks were anticipating if he was going to hit something hard to the gap, it was going to be to left center more than right center. And he just missed that one.
Here's Crawford. Crawford, a sacrifice fly to give the Giants the lead in the seventh. And strike, and it's 0-1.
This ballpark, you'd love to have one more insurance run going to the ninth. But runs tonight have been hard to find. Really have seen some outstanding pitching from both teams.
Crawford takes it, one ball and one strike. Juan Perez on deck. He'd like to hit here in the ninth. And a bunt. Is it good enough? Not in time. I can't remember the last time I saw Crawford do this.
I don't even remember seeing him do it in spring training. You talk about a complete sneak attack. And Owens playing the cut of the grass. With De La Rosa falling off towards the third base side, as left-handers will do, Crawford opts to take it with him. Diamondbacks are looking at this play and they'll see that Crawford indeed did beat it.
Second hit for Crawford. Here's Perez. Perez taps it to third. Pennington side retired. So we will go to the bottom of the ninth. It'll be Trumbo to lead things off. 2-1 Giants.
This time he's come into a game. 2-3 with a 1.89 ERA, 15 saves. For Garcia, he's allowed 50 base runners at 52 in the third, which is outstanding whip. Walks and hits combined in his pitch. 40 strikeouts. And 40 strikeouts against 15 walks. How's he doing? Well, low to mid 90s with velocity. He'll give you two and four seam fastballs, curveball, slider, changeup, and for a closer, you're not used to a guy coming at you with all five types of movement. He will give you those looks, and he will throw any of those pitches in a 3-2. But for Garcia, as always, always important to get strike one. It really calms him down.
Yeah. So here's Trumbo. And a strike, and it's 0-1.
You would think that that was a big deal for a big league pitcher, but it is, especially with Casilla.
And the next pitch just inside, one ball and one strike.
Casilla, like every other Giants pitcher last night, saw him go deep against Vogelsong with a fastball away, and he hit it to right field. Just missed. Good hook. So ahead quickly 0-1. He had two pitches to nibble, and to Trumbo's credit, he laid off both those. And now with the 2-1 count, he's got to bite off a little more strike zone.
Three and one.
And now he's got to get in there. And this is where the big guys get rich.
So a first pitch strike, and then the next three out of the strike zone, one of them close. Tapped up the middle. Crawford, off balance throw. Got him! What a play by Brandon Crawford.
They weren't playing him up the middle either. And this is a quick infield. I didn't think he had a chance once it got past Casilla. And the reason I thought, number one, they couldn't get to it, and even if they did, I didn't think that Crawford could get off a throw. There you see strike one. He misses inside. Here's the 1-1 curveball. It's low. He goes back inside, misses. And here's the ground ball back up the middle. And Crawford from the right foot, a strike to Ishikawa, and that is a huge first out.
Wow. Here's Montero. You don't get many plays like that in this infield because it's so fast. And consequently, you really don't get to show what kind of range you have on fast infields. But that one, you saw what Crawford can do. Here it's 0-1 to Montero. Montero gets jammed. It's no balls and two strikes.
Such a nice two-pitch sequence there. He opened him up a two-seam movement, running away with the nail. Strike one in the outside corner at the knees. And then he comes back with 95 and cuts him on the hands. I mean, that's just shaving both sides of the plate with two types of movement. And he's a quick on top of low two. You could bounce a curveball here. You could go above the hands with a fastball. Posey says stay away with heat.
Another look at how far Crawford went to his left. See, that's a hit. Then you're thinking, well, maybe he's got a chance. Then you're thinking, well, what kind of throws he going to be able to make?
I mean, that's the whole point. I mean, fortunately, Trumbo doesn't have a lot of speed. And it took him a while to get unwound, to get going down that line.
Got him.
That doors him with a nice curveball.
So here's Pennington. Pennington is bounced out, lined out, and flied out. It's 0-1. 26,339 here tonight. Low and in. Even the count at a ball and a strike.
They play slightly the left center with Perez in center. They're pitching that gap.
Perez, ball game. Giants win a game that they didn't have to win, but they needed to win. So the updated standings on a night where Jake Peavy was sensational. Giants now are three back of the Dodgers, and they're up 2.5 on the Pirates.
Well, you can't say enough about Jake Peavy tonight, and he really came out and established that he had all of his pitches early, and he matched zeros with Josh Collmenter, and that's not an easy thing to do when you're on the road. And this is a gutty win. When you're turning around a worm, it's never an easy victory. Tonight was huge.
I love when you turn around that worm. Final score, it's the Giants 2 and the D-backs 1. Eastern's Giants postgame live is coming up, but first, let's